In the last lesson, we pointed out that in the presence of oxygen, pyruvate and reduced NAD have a different fate. They enter into the mitochondrion. Welcome again. In today's lesson, we explain aerobic respiration, including the link reaction, the Krebs cycle, the role of NADH and H+, the electron transport chain, and the role of oxygen. We explain oxidative phosphorylation in terms of chemiosmosis, and we explain the relationship between the structure of the mitochondrion and its function. Pyruvate is the end product of glycolysis. In the absence of oxygen, pyruvate becomes the final acceptor for the hydrogens on reduced NAD. But when oxygen is present, both the pyruvate and the NAD have a different fate. Pyruvate enters by active transport into the matrix of the mitochondrion. Once in the matrix, pyruvate associates with coenzyme A. In this process, a decarboxylation, or a loss of carbon dioxide, occurs. In addition, there is an oxidation, or a loss of hydrogen, from the pyruvate as NAD+, the acceptor, is reduced. The link reaction. For it links, glycolysis, which occurs in the cytoplasm of the cell, with a cycle of reactions that occur first in the matrix of the mitochondrion, and then leads on to reactions that happen on the cristae of the mitochondrion. This cycle of reactions that happens in the matrix begins with the two-carbon structure that forms from pyruvate and its association with coenzyme A, combining with a four-carbon molecule to produce a six-carbon molecule. It's important to note that this is a simplification and that several enzymes are associated with these reactions. The six-carbon structure, or the citric acid, undergoes several transformations. At some stages, there are decarboxylations, and at several stages, there is the reduction of NAD. This cycle, or Krebs cycle, can be summarized in this way, with three reductions of NAD and another acceptor, FAD, also associated with the process. And at one of the stages, sufficient energy is released to allow for the direct combination of adenosine diphosphate with inorganic phosphate, the so-called substrate level phosphorylation, which also happens in glycolysis. In this series of reactions, the process can continue as more pyruvate enters and more acetyl coenzyme A is formed. It can combine with the four-carbon structure to continuously produce a supply of the 6-carbon citric acid and to allow for the continuous rotation of the Krebs cycle. The significant event in this cycle is the removal of hydrogen, the oxidation of the molecules in the cycle, and the reduction of NAD+. The significance of the reduction of the hydrogen acceptor, NAD+, becomes obvious when we consider the events occurring in these little foldings or the cristae of the mitochondrion. For it is in here that the significant process which yields energy for the cell occurs. If we were to magnify this membrane several times and look at the outside of the crista, which is the matrix of the mitochondrion, the membrane itself and the space within the membrane, then it would be possible to see the structures involved in the process of chemiosmosis as the electrons from the hydrogens accepted by NAD become passed through a series of acceptors, each one having a stronger affinity or attraction for electrons. As these electrons flow from one acceptor to the next, sufficient energy is released to allow for the hydrogen ions here in the matrix to be moved or pumped against a concentration gradient and to build up a high concentration in this tiny area between the membranes. There are several such infoldings which increase the surface area, and the fact that the pockets are very small means that the ion concentration becomes high at a faster rate. Once this concentration is high enough, then the hydrogen ions move through a special transmembrane channel which comprises the enzyme ATP synthase. And as the ions flow from the high concentration that was built inside the crista out into the matrix, ATP is produced from ADP and inorganic phosphate with the use of the energy of the moving hydrogen ions. Chemiosmosis, a very similar, if not identical, process happens across the thylakoid membranes of chloroplasts. But just as pyruvate worked as the final acceptor of glycolysis, removing the hydrogens picked up by NAD+, the mitochondrion, in aerobic respiration, there is the need for a final acceptor. For where would the electrons transfer here through these series of acceptors ultimately go? And where would all of the hydrogen ions ultimately go? If there is no final stage in this conveyor belt, then the entire process could come to a grinding halt. This final stage in the manufacturing of ATP requires the consumption of oxygen, a very highly electronegative element. Oxygen quickly associates with the two electrons, requiring a negative charge. The summary equation for respiration reads this way, with glucose seemingly reacting with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide, water, and energy. But it is certainly not a case of oxygen being added to glucose to oxidize it. For the oxidations and reductions that occur in both the mitochondria and the chloroplasts involve losses of electrons, losses of hydrogen, but there are no examples of gains of oxygen or losing of oxygen. So the definition of oxidation and reduction in biological systems could be simplified to look at oxidation as the loss and reduction as the gain, a loss of hydrogens and electrons in oxidation and a gain of hydrogens and electrons in reduction through a series of oxidations. By the removal of hydrogen, glucose is stripped in a very gradual process, beginning with glycolysis and continuing in the matrix of the mitochondrion. As this happens, carbon dioxide is also released. Eventually, all of the hydrogens are disposed of by combining with oxygen, the final acceptor in aerobic respiration. Let's consider some final questions that bring together the two key organelles, the mitochondria and the chloroplast. Consider aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration.